Hi guys, welcome to Teppy. The picture is black. This is on purpose. My iPad's just sitting on a pillow with the camera facing at the pillow. It's black because I'd like you people to have a deep thought. The name of and title of this video is called When Did My Life Go Wrong? When Did My Life Go Wrong explains, well, when my life went wrong, obviously. And it's a bit of a maniac video explaining about how five different people are agreeing on the same thing, a decision that my mum made to make my life go wrong, which was wrong to make it go. Oh, what the fuck am I saying? So this video is going to have some maniac sounding music along to go with it, and my mum's worryingly low mental capacity. That's not really that though, she just had a low mental capacity at the time of the move, that was all it was. So what this is talking about is basically when I spent 7 amazing years in Newcastle, wasting all my time in a good school, going all the way up to year 10. Before the druggie took me back down to Southampton and fucked the rest of my life up. And here I am, still not in school, still not in college, still not with a hard job. Had I stayed in Newcastle till now, I would have had a job. There's no fucking doubt about it. At all in my mind. Or anyone else's mind. If there is, they should die. Okay. So, my foster carer Pauline, my nanny Melody, my great auntie Sonia, my auntie Deanne, and me, right? Five different people. Know for a fact that had my mum not had the twins, had we not moved down from Newcastle, she could have had the twins, we could have stayed in Newcastle, okay? My bedroom could have been the shed. My life, had we have done that, would have been no different. I would have had a job by now, guys. My YouTube channel would be 3 million times as amazing. I'd have 15 million subscribers by now. My electric channel probably wouldn't even exist because my life being better would have probably made Andy's life better. I don't know. My channel probably would have still exist because I remember in Newcastle, that was like when I actually watched the very last video he'd made and seen everything that's gone wrong. So my channel would have existed anyway. In fact, actually it might not have, because the only reason it's really there is because I'm in sort of my own place where no one really complains about my electrical things that I do. So I can do my other channel, Photon 2, go into my channel of Teppy, of course. Check the channels tab, go and start looking. I do stuff with safety, I do stuff on top of the metal dish. I used to be doing stuff in the window, but I want to be near a water in case something catches fire. That's just why I'm now doing stuff in the bathroom. So, yeah, it's less ventilated. I've got a massive bedroom with a massive window in a massive house. There's plenty of air. You know, that's not going to have any problems. I do know what I'm doing in case anyone's wondering. How do you think I know what I'm doing? Because I watch electronic people, I listen to what they say, I memorise every single thing. And I'm only doing this with, what, 20 volts? It's nothing. So, yeah. I hope you guys are going to enjoy this video. Expect some maniac music. You might laugh. The music might make you laugh. It made me laugh when I first heard it. This is just going to be a mismatch of Minecraft pictures. Pictures I've got on Google Earth that I've distorted to make look more right. And real pictures of the house itself that I've got. The really bad resolution and stuff. They're all off my mum's iPad Air. You know, I've trimmed them so it's just pictures of the house, or mostly pictures of the house. If there's any pictures of my sister or a dog or a tortoise, that just be in the garden or on the floor or whatever. I haven't got any pictures of the twins. I want them out of my mind for a bit because they're the reason I'm down here. Pretty much because my mum couldn't get a bigger house anywhere. Had the flood in 2012 not happened, she may or may not have still had the 3-bedroom house with a massive office bedroom downstairs that was being used as a bedroom anyway, because that was my mum's bedroom. The bedroom upstairs that was left spare was actually my playroom, that would have been Leilani's room, the twins would have had the little one. We would have basically been in the same house that we're in now. Just Newcastle. It's basically that. Different shape and all that stuff, but same house. You know? The stairs still kind of went up in a spiral-ish shape. You know. We could have even been in the same three-bedroom house just with the shed as my bedroom. Not insulated, obviously, because I don't like insulation. How hot it's getting, I don't want it. Twins could have had my bedroom, although my bedroom was my favourite, personally. But but me being the oldest child, it would have been the best idea for me to be in a shed. It would have been tiny and small. But at the same time, I would have had my own sink. I could have repaired the outside toilet, let's say, get plumbing to it. I could have my own outside toilet. I could basically have my own kitchen, my own toilet, in my bedroom, like all that. Do you know what I mean? My own cupboard could go into the little storage bit that sort of wrapped around the back of it, which was next to the toilet, in between the shed door and the toilet door outside. The pipe was still there. It was all blocked off and stuff, but the pipe was still there. I could have had that though. And, you know, being a garden, I could have a place to sort of vent my anger and stuff in the garden, like even at night if I wanted to go out and do something nice. Do you know what I mean? Could have done all that. Newcastle's not exactly the place where people are going to go and vandalise, so I'm pretty safe. I mean, there was a lock, I think, both on the outside and the inside of the shed door, if I'm not wrong. No, yeah, there was actually the lock key bit itself. I could lock myself in, do you know what I mean? The key was a little bit finicky because it was an old one, but old is better anyway. And then my sister's bedroom would have been the same, mum's bedroom would have been the same, everything else would have been the same, except the twins would be in my room and I'd be in the shed. I even told her about that while we were in Newcastle. And she still didn't care. She just wanted to ruin my life, just to get a hit out of it. And the only time I've been hitting my mum is, well, I think I hit her like one or two times actually before she had the twins. But that was actually while she was pregnant. So that was still irritation of the babies anyway. And then when she had the twins, that's when the batterings have actually started. But even though I'm an asshole and no one liked me hitting my mum, I still believe that she deserved every single beating she got. Not that it's right, I know that. I've learnt my lesson. I'm not gonna hit her again. I'm not gonna hit her again anyway because I ain't around her. No, I'm not gonna hit her again anyway. I don't want to. Stupid. Anyway, she didn't deserve the beatings, but I have that guilty goodness around it. Do you know what I mean? Like, you know, that rebellious sort of feeling, like that sort of victorious sort of feeling. You know what I mean? You know when you hit a bad guy in the game and you think, ah, oh, that's what you deserve, you asshole. It's not that sort of thing. My mum didn't actually deserve it, but, you know, I still have that thing about it, you know. My anger's vented. Yeah, onto the video. Long enough talk.